Welcome back to the Ark, our little play on Aberration. We now have both our babies and we're going to take them out for a spin. Mainly just learning to work with two of them. Because there's kind of a trick to it. You don't want the other one in front of you. So there's a lot of spinning and turning and jumping. Stuff like that. Hello, where'd you go? Uh-oh. Looked like it fell. That was... fail! Alright, we'll try again. So... crosshair, jump! See? Where it jumped in front of you? You spin around underneath, walk in front, turn back over, and then it's following you. So now we're following. Alright. Make sure it's got enough. Uh-oh. Earthquake! I think the distance. You can change the distance between the two of them. I'm gonna put it on medium. So is it crowding it so much? Let me see if we like that. Pretty good distance. Alright. Let's go get into some trouble. I like that distance. It's kind of far away. Let's see. Let's change it to low. See how close it is. I like that better. You can test it yourself and do whatever you like. Whatever you're comfortable with, of course. Run around, get into trouble. Yeah. And when you're on the top dog, or rabbit, it'll glow as an owl. All you have to do is attack and the other one will help. Soft target won't fight back. Both of these guys get up to speed, you know. The problem is that I've got some kind of random pixelation going on. Another problem too is that your pack doesn't do the Nash attack like the wild ones do. That's kind of a crappy thing. It's kind of one of the cool features. But whatever. I like the following distance because you can see the head coming into it and you know it's behind you. You can have as many in your pack as you want, but it's really kind of difficult to travel with. Because you constantly have to worry that so one of the pack people get, stuck. It's got plenty of food. Okay, we're gonna go over here and let's see if we can do some vine climbing. We're back at the lake. Well, the little creek that leads to the lake. Or runs off the lake. Don't know. What do you do? Up there, you can see a drop. So I think maybe I'll put down a line here, and it'll give us an opportunity to climb up to the next level. Let's see, let's see metal nodes up there. The more, the merrier. So we'll lay the line down here and we'll shoot it up. There, I guess. I don't know. Somewhere. Yeah, you see those random pixelations and all that kind of crap? It's a corrupted file. I didn't figure that out till too late. So sorry about the quality there. I was having a lot of crashes and stuff like that, so. Bear with me. I will get this. Alright, remember what we said about this. So I can't flip here. Can't flip there. Okay, this is a problem when you have to kind of go faster and get further ahead on your jump. That way it's far enough behind you. There's an alligator. He wants to eat us. He's very excited about that. It's level 4? Was that the next? Okay. Wrong thing. So I can shoot him from here. That's another good thing about these mounts, is that you can fire from the saddle. So yay. But I think maybe I'll have to be upside down for this. I don't know. Hello. Can't see it. It's like it's straight under us. I can't see it. Yeah. Nothing unusual about that. Put it in the wrong place. I'll fix it later. Oh. I think that's not close enough to that top one. Let's see if I can hit it. I didn't realize how far off I was. This is a problem you'll have to learn. Let's see if I can hit him. Uh-oh. You don't have 360 on these saddles either. What to do, what to do. Let's flip over. Alright. I wonder if I can shoot down a little bit. Now look. That's hanging upside down. Much, much better, much better. Now I'm guessing the reason that the other rabbit's not going down there and attacking is because it's on the wire with me and it's on follow. I don't know. Frankly, I don't care. I like it when it slides, it makes sparks. Here comes the gator. Let's hit it. But you have to remember, I recorded this prior to the TLC on the alligators, which have been added a new twist. They can do a new twist, and they also can dismount you. They can grab you and take you off your mount. So this is prior to that. Free fill up, thank you very much. Now there's a nice carcanos down there that we will be trying to tame at some point. Okay. Basically just see how the thing follows and how they work together as a team. I'd like to get another one. I think it could handle three. One and two following. And it's about to level up. Real easy to heal it up. See about the other one. We've just been going around killing little stuff. We got the alligator. Boom, boom, boom. Got a few supplies, so that's awesome. Now there's a green symbol up in the right hand corner. Alpha, I guess. Uh-oh, can't flip there. Okay, see, the main purpose that I have for these animals is that they can come up here to these second levels and we can get tons of metal. Ta-da! That's taking a minute. We'll make sure we have them at the same speed and weight. And then we can level up their melee. Well, that's my goal. Okay, I spotted another Ravager. It's a level 4. Oh! I like it when I level up. I think I need speed. So I want to keep them even. Alright, let's get this one. See how they work together? Fabulous. But I still got mashed. But I just heal. Easy as pie. I like it a lot. I like it. Yeah, we're just kind of just messing around. See what how they work together and see if we find anything new. And I just hit, you know, like easy stuff at the beginning because I don't know what they're capable of doing yet. We'll build up. That's the way I always train or train up. My favorite part of this game is leveling. Really animal training them. And this is my method. You know, I don't jump in and start it, you know, with the hard stuff. I start with the easy stuff if I can. Look, there's a box here. And the reason I didn't get it now is because I already have it in my regular game with my tribe. And I have promised you a video for to give you a tour of our base, which I love this base. It's really cool concept. But I'll tell you all about that later. Okay. Enough of that. What was that? Is that a bee? Is that a bee going rah, rah? I don't know. I don't know what that was. I guess it was the bee. Wah, wah. Taming bees is a tricky, nasty business. Need to wreck some armor with that stuff for sure. Okay, I know you know what asking what happened. I lost some footage, but what happened is we jumped in the water and the piranhas attacked and these guys have gone nuts. Wreaking havoc trying to get control back over my dogs. If you jump off or if you get dismounted, your animals are going to defend you. It may be hard to catch up with them, so you kind of have to think what you're doing. You don't want them fighting by themselves, and you don't want to be left, you know. Now they're okay. See what happened. They're not the best swimmers. They can climb and jump and run, but they're not very good swimmers. They can swim, but they're not that great at it. They're vulnerable in water. Oh, now it did it again. It was definitely the bee. Guess they don't like it. So just be careful when you're going in the water because of those stupid, stupid piranhas. I have no idea what I just checked. I think it was the wave. So we're going home the well-worn route to the house. Because I've had enough. Take home our goodies, a little bit of stuff that we gathered, and I think it was a good run. We're figuring out what these guys can do and what they do together. You just have to experiment. We will be going to the surface. We will be going to the blue zone. We will be taming Carcanos and a rock drake and all that good stuff. I don't know how long it'll take. I don't know if we'll be successful, but we will try. There it is. Home sweet home. Now let's see if my method of putting them away is easy as I think it would be. There's a one or not. Alright, let's Let's see if we can do this. Jump. Ah! Yeah. Yeah, it's frustrating. You really gotta get used to doing it. Just keep going. Just keep going. Just go, 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 go. There you go. Alright, that was step one. Now we jump on the other one. Flip, flip, flip. There we go. Flip. And up. And over. And turn around. And there you go. And jump. And land. And done. Alright. Well, that worked out really great. Some things work and some things don't. Alright, now I just need to unload everything and... crap. Alright, maybe that plan didn't work so great. Tell you one thing I can't wait to get is some wings. So when I jump off stuff, I can fly. Flying is one of the fun parts of this. The hooks and flying combo, you can get around just about anywhere. Alright, you go in there and I'm going to unload all these... critters and creatures, and I want to thank everybody for watching my videos. All two. Hopefully there'll be more. It'll catch on. You know, I really like making them, and it helps. It helps a lot. And this is a great game, despite all its flaws. And quirks and glitches. But I love it. I really, really do. So, again, thank you so much for watching, and we will talk to you later. Bye!